and made four demands. Number one, as you know, that video in which Sriram Malu, along with others and the son-in-law of the ex-Chief Justice of India, who later became the chairman of the Human Rights Commission, that talks about the kind of bribes that were given, and this is all on video, which is circulating. So one, we said that on the basis of this video, a FIR should be registered against all those who are participating in these corrupt deals with the judiciary. And that includes Sriram Malu, who is a candidate of the BJP in this election. So a registration of the FIR has gone through. Number one, yesterday, while this was circulating on TV channels, the CEO, Chief Election Officer in Karnataka, banned the showing of this particular video on television channels in Karnataka. So we said that this ban must be lifted, because this is freedom of expression, and once the media is in the public video is in the public domain, talking about the ill-gotten gains and the kind of deals that are going on between politicians and the judiciary, this must be part of the public discourse, to the extent to which the judiciary as well as the political class has degenerated in getting favorable orders. As you know, one day before the retirement of the Chief Justice of India, an order was given favorable to Sriram Malu and Janardan the Reddy brothers. You are aware of that. That's the second demand that we have made. The third demand that we have made is that the election in which Sriram Malu is standing should be countermanded immediately. There should be no election in that. He should be disqualified from contesting the election. He must not be allowed to contest this election, because he has been involved in bribery and he is involved in these nefarious activities. That is the third demand that we have made. And the fourth demand that we have made is there are very, very, very serious issues that are arising in the involvement of the BJP in spreading hatred amongst the voters in Karnataka by putting up promos in Chandrasekhar's channel. As you know, he's a regional channel there. He's put promos there which says, are you going to be associated with nationalist forces or forces that will disintegrate India, thereby meaning nationalist forces being BJP and the forces of disintegrating India mean the Congress party. Now this kind of hatred cannot be the basis of campaigning, because that itself is the subject matter of illegal and corrupt practices under the Representation of People's Act. And since no petitions can be filed at this stage, naturally the Commission is entitled to exercise its powers under Article 324 of the Constitution of India, and we have requested the Commission to exercise that power to make sure that such kind of promos and campaigns in the form of advertisement should not be allowed to be circulated on a channel which is controlled by the BJP. And also on the social media, what is being shown is the Congress flag along with the Pakistani flag. This itself is the worst form of communal campaigning that can happen in this country while the election process is on, and we've requested the Election Commission to ensure that this must be stopped immediately, because voting takes place tomorrow. And if no urgent action is taken, then the whole election process will be vitiated, and that should not happen. The only institution in this country, because courts cannot interfere, as you know, when the election is announced, when the notification is issued, courts cannot interfere. We cannot go by way of a writ petition. The only power is the power of the Election Commission under Article 324 of the Constitution, and we requested the Election Commission on all these four counts, especially when a person involved in 35,000 crores ghapla in Karnataka, who has also been jailed and embraced by the present Prime Minister of India and is going along with him stage after stage in campaigning, if such people are allowed to continue to contest elections, it will be a travesty of justice and of the election process. Thank you very much.
Chunav Aayog ko mila teen muddon ko lekar. BJP ka ab naya naam Bhrasht Janardan Party ban gaya hai. Pure desh ne dekha जिस प्रकार से कर्नाटक में पिछली यदुरप्पा सरकार के कार्यकाल में 35,000 करोड़ रुपए का खनन घोटाला हुआ, उस 35,000 करोड़ रुपए के खनन घोटाले में सुप्रीम कोर्ट के पूर्व जज संतोष हेगड़े साहब जी ने जो लोक आयुक्त थे, तथ्यों और साक्ष्यों के आधार पर रेड्डी ब्रदर्स को बाकायदा दोषी पाया। आज फिर प्रधानमंत्री मोदी और भाजपा येड्डी रेड्डी गैंग के साथ मिलकर कर्नाटक का चुनाव लड़ रही है। कल एक सनसनीखेज घोटाला हमारे कन्नड़ा टेलीविजन चैनल्स द्वारा किया गया, जिसमें टीवी 9, पब्लिक टीवी, वी टीवी, सिद्धि टीवी, राज टीवी, कई हमारे साथियों ने यह स्पष्ट तौर से दिखाया कि जो घोटाला हुआ था 35,000 करोड़ रुपए का, उसमें बाकायदा रिश्वत उच्चतम स्तर पर न्यायपालिका तक दी गई थी। हमने केवल 4 स्पष्ट मांगे चुनाव आयोग के समक्ष रखी हैं। पहली, बी श्री रमल्लू जो मोदी जी का ब्लू आइड बॉय है और जो इन वीडियोस के अंदर साफ तौर से रिश्वत के लेन देन की चर्चा करता स्पष्ट दिख रहा है, उस व्यक्ति को चुनाव लड़ने का कोई अधिकार नहीं रहा इन करप्ट प्रैक्टिसेस के चलते। बी श्री रमल्लू को दोनों विधानसभाओं से चुनाव लड़ने से प्रतिबंधित किया जाए। दूसरा, सीईओ कर्नाटका के द्वारा प्रेस की आज़ादी का हनन करते हुए कन्नड़ा टेलीविजन चैनल्स को वो टेप दिखाने पर प्रतिबंध लगा दिया गया। ये संवैधानिक अधिकारों का हनन है और हमने अनुरोध किया कि उस आदेश को खारिज कर दिया जाए ताकि टेलीविजन चैनल अपनी मर्जी से उस कंटेंट को दिखा सके। तीसरा, हमने ये अनुरोध भी चुनाव आयोग को किया कि प्रिवेंशन ऑफ करप्शन एक्ट और भारतीय दंड संहिता यानी इंडियन पीनल कोड के तहत बी श्री रमल्लू और भारतीय जनता पार्टी के नेताओं पर फौरन मुकदमा दर्ज कर उन्हें गिरफ्तार किया जाए। इसके अलावा एक और रिप्रेजेंटेशन कांग्रेस पार्टी ने चुनाव आयोग को दी, जिसमें ये कहा गया है कि 2 टेलीविजन चैनल विशेष तौर से भारतीय जनता पार्टी का प्रचार प्रसार कर रहे हैं और एक षड्यंत्र के तहत कांग्रेस को बदनाम करने की साजिश कर रहे हैं। उनमें से एक टेलीविजन चैनल के मालिक हैं श्री राजीव चंद्रशेखर, जो भारतीय जनता पार्टी से कर्नाटक के सांसद भी हैं। ऐसे टेलीविजन चैनल पर इस प्रकार की भड़काऊ बातें दिखाने के लिए प्रतिबंध लगाया जाए और सोशल मीडिया के माध्यम से एक हारी हुई और हताश भाजपा अब एक बार फिर बिहार और जम्मू कश्मीर की तरह और उत्तर प्रदेश के चुनाव की तरह कांग्रेस पार्टी के खिलाफ षड्यंत्र कर रही है। भाजपा पर और उसके नेताओं पर उसके लिए मुकदमा दर्ज किया जाए। आई विल वेरी ब्रीफली से वन मोर थिंग। कांग्रेस पार्टी पॉइंटेड आउट दैट द करप्ट प्रैक्टिसेस ऑफ श्री बी श्री रमल्लू आर नाउ मोर देन अपेरेंट बाय वे ऑफ द टेप्स दैट आर अवेलेबल इन द जज ब्राइबरी केस। लेट him be disqualified from contesting in Karnataka as an assembly candidate. We also demanded that a case under Prevention of Corruption Act and under Indian Penal Code be lodged against Shri B. Shri Ramallu and other BJP leader and let him and others be arrested. We demanded that the order of CEO Karnataka prohibiting Kannada TV channels from showing the judge bribery case tapes is illegal and unconstitutional and that order be withdrawn. We also demanded that the 2 bhag channels of BJP are running a concerted conspiracy and agenda to malign the Congress party through their hashtags and promos, one of which is now owned by Shri Rajiv Chandrasekhar. Let action be taken against these 2 television channels and the malfeasance that is being spread through social media. Action be taken. Thank you.